This hour, former Federal Reserve Chairman Paul Volcker is scheduled to speak about the need for financial regulatory reform. Joining us now to discuss this issue, I'm joined by Brian Gardner, Senior Vice President of Washington Research at Keefe, Bruyette and Woods. He joins us now from the nation's capital. Brian, welcome to Bloomberg News. Thank you so much for coming on.
Sure thing, Mark. Good afternoon.
We're seeing that Mr. Volcker is just getting set to speak, so let me ask you quickly, do you think that the Volcker rule is a good idea?
No, I don't. I think it's a solution in search of a problem. Even the chairman acknowledges that this was not the prop trading issue, the sponsorship of hedge funds and private equity funds was not part of the recent financial crisis. Could it be a problem down the road? Yes, but I don't think that the Volcker approach is the right one to control this. I think it's all about capital.
Why do you say that? Do you believe there's a misunderstanding here of exactly how banks work?
I think there's a fundamental misunderstanding. I think, largely, these activities do not take place in banks as we think of them, the entity that takes insured deposits. It happens in a non-bank sub of a holding company. It's affiliated with a bank, but insured deposits are not funding the activities that we're talking about here.
How significant a point is that?
I think it's a highly significant fact because I think the public perception of those who support it is that that insured deposits are at risk here,
and that's not the case. Yeah, and Brian, I didn't mean to interrupt you, but I wanted to ask you, is that part of the problem? Do you believe that that's been lost in the debate?
I think it's been totally lost in the debate. People throw the term bank around very loosely, but there's a firm legal definition of a bank, and then the non-bank entities, and it's the non-bank entity that should be allowed to take more risk. It doesn't have the same FDIC exposure because of insured deposits.
Will this affect the playing field, do you think? Will the Volcker rule put banks at a competitive advantage or disadvantage?
If it goes through, I think at a competitive disadvantage. Look, the U.S. banks that are engaged in prop trading and sponsor hedge funds, it's a smaller percentage of their business than I think a lot of people understand. But competitively worldwide, the Europeans and the Asian banks do not want to go along with this. It's a bigger business, especially prop trading, I think, is a bigger business for them. And the EU and the Asian finance ministers, I think, have signaled pretty clearly that they are not in line with the Volcker thinking on this and are not going to be going forward on this.
Okay, Brian, if not the Volcker rule, then what?
Then capital. It's all about capital. I think that's the right approach that the Treasury Secretary has enunciated, capital, capital, capital. As the banking regulators look at revising the capital rules, which they are now undergoing, I think you'll see institutions that engage in these type of activities will be required to hold higher levels of capital to buffer any potential losses in the future. That's the way to go.
Brian, where do you weigh in then on the too big to fail mantra?
Well, too big to fail, you know, has to end, and I think it's going to end. I think the Dodd approach is actually a pretty good one. It walls off the institutions from federal lending. It restricts the Fed's ability to engage in emergency lending to specific institutions. I think Senator Dodd's come up with a really good approach on that. And if you start to signal to investors, especially fixed income investors, that a bank that is failing, an institution that's failing, is going to go into this new resolution scheme and it's going to fail, you potentially could lose money. I think that starts to bring in the market discipline that has been surely lacking, and I think that goes a long way to ending too big to fail.
So is this a question in your mind of just enforcing the rules that we already have on the books, or are better capital rules required?
You know, I think some rules have to be tweaked. I think that, you know, getting back to your question on too big to fail, I think the resolution scheme in the United States really has to be updated to include non-banks, the holding companies of banks, which are not currently included in the FDIC scheme. I think that has to change. Then the regulators already have a lot of power to change the capital rules. Matter of fact, there really are no provisions in Treasury or the congressional proposals on changing capital rules because the regulators already have that authority. They need to go in, update the rules. They are doing that. It's an ongoing process. It's going on internationally. We're seeing proposals coming out from Basel, and you're going to see formal proposals coming out from U.S. banking regulators in the coming months.
So, Brian, in 15 seconds, does the Volcker rule pass?
not as proposed by the administration. You may see some language that's going to be very soft, very weak, that basically re-enunciates current law, but you will not see, I do not believe we'll see, a strict separation of prop trading and banking.
Brian Gardner, Senior Vice President of Washington Research at Keefe, Bruyette & Woods. Brian, thank you so much. We appreciate it.